What I'm going to show you today is how you can use the MySQL autopilot features, which Edward talked about, and use it with our publicly posted benchmark to verify the results. I'm going to start off with the first feature, which is auto-provisioning. So for that, we're going to log in to an instance of the MySQL database, which has 4 terabytes of the TPCS data loaded. The first step is to determine what's the right size of a HeatWave cluster. For most of the services out there, the onus is on the application to determine what's the optimal cluster size. With MySQL Autopilot, users can invoke the MySQL advisor, and this advisor, the only input that is required is the schema or the table on which you want to run analytics. So we're going to select the TPCS schema, and the system tells you very accurately how much of memory is going to be used and what is the size of the cluster that is required. This is fairly interactive, where you can go and deselect some of the tables if you want to see what change will it make in terms of the recommendation. So when we deselect the line item table, which is the largest table, you see that the size of the cluster reduced from 12 nodes to 4 nodes. But since we are going to be using TPCH as the working example, we're going to go back and select the entire TPCS schema. And the system is recommending that we create a cluster of 12 nodes, and that's what we're going to do. And with this, now we are provisioning a MySQL HeatWave cluster with 12 nodes per the recommendation of auto-provisioning. Once the cluster has been provisioned, the next step is to load data from the MySQL database into the HeatWave cluster. So for this, we're going to invoke the AutoLoad advisor. The AutoLoad advisor does two things. The first is, based on the data which is going to be loaded into the HeatWave cluster, it determines how much of memory is required on the HeatWave cluster and how much of memory is required on the MySQL node. And if it turns out that the memory requirement is larger than what the system has, it's going to issue a warning before the load starts. The second thing is, for each of the table which is going to be loaded into the HeatWave cluster, it determines what's the optimal degree of parallelism. The optimal degree of parallelism is such that it minimizes the load time, at the same time minimizes the memory requirement. So what you will see over here is that for the line item table, it's picking a degree of parallelism of 32, and for the nations table, it's picking up a different degree of parallelism. Once the data has been loaded into the memory of the HeatWave cluster, this loading is done based on the primary key. So the primary key is the default key on which the data is partitioned in the memory. Based on this partitioning, we run the 22 TPCH queries, and we see that with this default partitioning, it takes about 18 minutes to execute the queries. We're now going to invoke the Auto Data Placement Advisor to see what recommendation it has. When we invoke the Auto Data Placement Advisor, the Data Placement Advisor makes a couple of recommendations. The first one is, it recommends if any of the tables which have been loaded into the memory need to be altered and repartitioned based on some other key. So in this case, it's making a recommendation that the line item table and the part supplier should be partitioned on a different key. The second thing which the advisor does is to predict the amount of savings you're going to get if you partition based on the new key. So the system is telling us that we're going to save 5.5 minutes if you follow the recommendation, and we're going to follow the recommendation and we execute the command to alter the partitioning in memory. Once the data has been repartitioned based on the new key, we're going to run the 22 queries again and see what the performance is. When we rerun the queries based on the recommended partitioning scheme from Autopilot, we see that the query time dropped from 18 minutes to 8.5 minutes. Now that we have the optimal partitioning in memory, the fourth feature I'm going to show for Autopilot is the auto query plan improvement. So for this, I'm going to connect with two different sessions. In the first session, I'm going to run query one, which is derived from one of the TPCH queries, and we're going to run on a fresh instance of the database. When we run query one, it takes about 2.5 minutes to execute query one. And there is no history on this instance of the database. Now, from another session, I'm going to run a different query, slightly different from query one, which I'm calling query two. Query two has some similarities with query one. So for instance, it's selecting from the same set of tables. It has some common predicates, but it also has some differences, like it has some different predicates as well. When we execute query two, the system learns from the execution of this query. For instance, what was the size of the intermediate results? So the system learns from the execution of query two. And then when we run query one in session two, it is going to come up with a better execution plan. So now when we run query one, we see that there is a significant improvement in performance in query one's execution. The execution time dropped from 2.5 minutes down to 30 seconds. And this is because of the autopilot, which is turned on by default.